really excited for two reasons. One, because I'm going to bake and share with you the recipe for snickerdoodle cookies. And the second reason, which is actually the bigger reason of excitement, is that I'm going to bake this along with my niece, who shares his passion for baking.
My name is Simran. I am 14 years old, love to bake. I am super excited to bake with my aunt today.
So while we are miles apart in our own kitchens, I think we are together in this journey, and thanks to Zoom for that. So first things first, I think we will get started, Simmi, with the ingredients. And I have all the ingredients ready here because that's the key to baking. If you are well prepared, I think the baking time reduces quite a bit. So in order to make the snickerdoodle cookie, all you need is 2.5 cups of all-purpose flour. I have it here. You need 1 3/4 cups of sugar. Now you have to divide the sugar in 2 portions. So I have 1.5 cups sugar in one bowl. Granulated sugar, you need to use granulated sugar. And I have 1/4 cup of sugar separated in another bowl. And I'll tell you why we have done this. Then we need 1 teaspoon of baking soda. We need 3/4 teaspoon of salt, which I have over here. We need 2 teaspoons of cream of tartar. Now, if you don't have a cream of tartar, you don't have to worry about it. You'll be fine without that. But if you have, you need 2 teaspoons of this. And then I have over here 1 tablespoon of cinnamon powder. So, Simmi, are you ready with all your ingredients?
Yeah, I have all the ingredients ready. The only difference is the all-purpose flour, instead of all-purpose flour, I've used maida, 2 cups maida along with 1/2 cup of all-purpose flour. And the butter, instead of unsalted butter because it wasn't available, I'm just using salted butter, but I'm going to skip the salt.
And, okay, yeah. Thank you. I think I missed to tell you, so you need 2 sticks, which is roughly 8 ounces of unsalted butter, and this should be softened. And the other ingredient which I missed were the 2 large eggs. You need 2 large eggs. And remember that your butter and your eggs should be at room temperature. Now the only difference between maida and all-purpose flour is the milling process. Maida is milled a little bit more than the all-purpose flour. So all-purpose flour actually has more protein as compared to maida. So that's the reason Simmi has just added 1/2 cup of whole wheat flour to the maida so that it gets to some texture which is close to all purpose. Okay, so we are going to get started, Simmi. The first thing what we need to do is to take our bowl of all purpose flour. We are going to add the salt. I'm using cream of tartar, so I'm going to use 2 teaspoons of cream of salt, tartar. And then we will add the baking soda that we have, 1 teaspoon of baking soda. Okay, so now what we are going to do is take a whisk, wire whisk, and just mix all of these together. We'll next come to creaming butter and sugar together. So the 1.5 cups of sugar that you have in a bowl, take it in a bigger bowl where you're going to cream, and to it add 8 ounces of softened unsalted butter. Okay, so if you have a hand mixer, start mixing. So mix it for 3 to 5 minutes until it is nice and creamy. You see the softened butter mix very well with the sugar. It almost will form like a cream. Remember to scrape the bowls by the side. order to make sure that everything mixes well. So I have this little scraper here. Okay, and we're going to beat this, as I said, for 3 to 5 minutes, and I think I'm almost there. Simi, are you ready? Okay.
Yeah.
So can you show how your mixture is looking like? So this is how it looks. Can you see? It's nice and creamy. So the eggs is the next ingredient that we are going to introduce in this batter. After creaming your sugar with butter, you need to add the 2 eggs, and you need to add one at a time. I already have the eggs broken over here, so I'm going to add them one by one. Here is my first egg.
So now we mix into the batter.
After having done that, I'm going to add the other egg to this batter. And then beat it to mix it. It's nice and yellow. Sure, you're scraping your bowl and you're blending the mixture to make sure everything is inside it. So you can start feeling the fluffiness in the batter. Okay, once we have done this, now we are slowly going to add the mixture that we have set aside. So Simi, are we there?
Yep.
Okay. So start adding this mixture little bit at a time. Do not try to add too much at one go. So I'm going to start adding a little bit of this and then beat to mix it.
As I'm going, I'm going to add this more. Okay. Now I'm absolutely fine to stop in between and then add the mixture.
Okay, so I'm adding a little bit of more the mixture. Okay, and this is the result. Okay, so this is the final one. So now I have mixed the batter. We have the batter ready actually. It's like a gooey dough that you will have at the end of this process. Now we are ready to bake. But before that, make sure that your baking tray is ready. I already have a cookie tray with a parchment paper lined and ready. So before we go there, we have this 1/4 cup of sugar and 1 tablespoon of cinnamon powder. Now we are going to mix.
I have a little plate over here.
So make sure that you mix them well. I can smell the cinnamon. It's nice and strong. So you will get this little brown colored sugar here because of the cinnamon powder in it. So next, what I'm going to do is, my dough is ready over here. I have this little mixture in which I'm going to roll the dough, and I have my tray ready here. So I'm going to pull my tray. I have this spoon in order to make sure that all my cookies are even sized. I'm going to use 1 spoon of this dough. Take it in your hand and remember, it's going to be a messy process. It's okay. Just take it in your hand and roll it into a ball. Okay, this is how it is. If you want bigger cookies, you can go for bigger dough balls. But here I have the medium one and I'm going to gently roll this in this sugar. With cinnamon. And I'm going to set this on my cookie sheet. So again, I'll take another spoonful in my hand and just roll it around in my palm and then place this on this mixture. Gently roll it in it so that it's covered with the cinnamon sugar. And then make sure that you leave 2 inches space between two balls so that when they are baking and they spread and they puff up, they don't merge with each other. Again, I have this third one. If you want to make smaller cookies, it's perfectly all right to do smaller dough balls. My third one. Simi, is it going well?
Yeah, it's going great.
Can you smell cinnamon?
Yep, it smells really good.
Yeah. They are really yummy. I like these cookies because they are nice and soft. They're absolutely light. When they get baked, you'll understand what I'm saying. Now we are ready with the dough balls. We have laid them on the cookie sheet almost 2 inches apart. And now we are going to set the tray inside the oven. We have already preheated our oven to 400 degree Fahrenheit, which is 200 degrees centigrade. And now it will take anywhere between 8 to 9 minutes for the cookies to be done. Okay, so here we go. Simi, let's get it inside the oven.
Yeah, I'm putting it in.
So I have it in my oven. Now I'm going to set the timer for 9 minutes. Nine minutes since we had set our cookies inside the oven, and it's time now. So we are going to now take the cookies out of our oven. So I have a wire rack here so that I can pull the tray and place it on the wire rack. Ooh, they look really good and they smell amazing. Amazing. So of course it's going to take some time for them to settle down and harden. You may find them a little softer when you try to touch them, but that's perfectly all right. So this is how they're going to look. So this is your base. It'll be a little bit more golden as compared to the top, but that's how it's supposed to be. Okay, so I have the snickerdoodle cookies ready. I just can't wait to eat them. How are they looking for you, Simi?
They look great, but they're kind of soft. But I think they'll harden with time.
Yes, they need to cool down and then you will see them hardening a little bit. And I think I'm really interested to hear from you how the cookies taste, because you have baked them with a little different ingredient, and that is adding wheat flour to your maida. So we'll give a couple minutes and then we will take a bite of this yummilicious snickerdoodle cookies. I'm going to first get started with Simi. Simi?
So this is the cookie.
Perfect. Did you like them?
No, they taste really good.
Okay. So here's my cookie. And I'm going to really break and show, you know, how nice and puffy they are inside. Can you see? Here they are. I just can't wait to taste them. Mm-hmm. I'm going to take a bite too. I can taste the cinnamon. The cookies are really light and they're so puffy. Amazing, outstanding. Simi, I really enjoyed baking along with you, and I'm looking forward to baking some more items with you.
It has been really fun. Thank you for inviting me. The cookies taste amazing.
Oh, it was my pleasure, Simmi. Okay, bye.
Yay, maza aa gaya.